The next indicator that I want to talk about is called RSI. RSI is arguably not only my favorite indicator, but it's also an indicator that's relevant to the environment today. Because of the second of the two applications that I will teaching you today. Now, pardon the text, but the first application is it's a momentum oscillator that swings from overbought to oversold conditions. To put it simply, your RSI indicator, it doesn't look complicated. It just has one line, whether it's a red line or a black line, that pretty much moves like a ping pong between horizontal lines. A top horizontal line and a bottom horizontal line. A top, when prices hit the top horizontal line, it just means prices are overbought. Which means that, remember our example a while ago where we had the first row buy a stock, it went up 5%, second row buy up another 5%, third row up another 5%, so on and so forth. When prices go up too high, too fast, too soon, it becomes overbought. So you'll see here in an uptrend line over here, you'll see that as prices reach overbought conditions, especially if it's in a 45-degree uptrend, you'll always see that that can be a starting point of duration. An overbought can be the beginning of when duration can start to happen, at least for 45-degree issues. But obviously, when you have small-cap issues that are hitting 60 degrees up, like MRC, PXP, TUGS, then obviously these are issues that can stay in overbought levels. But let's just look at mga big caps mo. Overbought and oversold can simply help you determine when duration can start to happen. Now, so what's the relevance of that? If it's overbought, especially if it's at a channel resistance, then you can simply use an overbought condition to lighten positions, right? Especially in sideways to upward moving environments. But typically when prices are in accelerating environments, such as let's say fourth quarter last year until January, where prices were moving higher at a much steeper ascent, then that's, I would typically not sell during overbought conditions at that point. Okay, the more important application for RSI is the second one. And I'm going to read it out for you. It can also spot out bullish or bearish divergence. Bullish and bearish divergence trades are actually one of my favorite setups to trade or favorite setups to enter or to exit a particular position. If you look here, what the divergence simply is that it is a leading indicator of lapse in momentum. It's a lapse in strength shown in the RSI versus the price. So this is actually one of the key ingredients that we've used to help navigate more than half or close to majority of all major tops and major bottoms, at least for the past 7 to 8 years. One of the key ingredients. And I'm going to show you how. Here, on the left side, we see here a bearish divergence, which shows you that price, yes, made a higher high, but you'll see that price has made a lower low, or RSI made a lower low in reading, which tells you that even though price was able to push to a higher high, what RSI is telling you that the momentum has already significantly waned or significantly been reduced. Or the momentum that pushed it to the new higher high is already significantly less than the momentum that pushed it to the first high. So it is actually one of the leading indicators of reversals. And besides using your uptrend line or your reversal patterns, one of the earliest ways you can sell a position, or you can catch selling a position, selling at the top, or one of the techniques that you can use for buying a position at the bottom is using divergent techniques. So let me show you some examples. So let's take out our MACD and include our RSI. So let's look for RSI over here. See RSI, you know, no need for modification. So let's zoom in. So I taught you a while ago how to participate in the first higher low in an uptrend using FIBO techniques. Now, next question is there any way we could have participated in buying the low before the uptrend started? If you'll see here, you can see a low, lower low, low, same low. Can you guys see that? Low, for a divergence to happen, at the minimum, it needs to hit the same level as the low. You guys follow? So here, nag-low siya at this level. And if you look closely, that's a low or a lower low. So you can that's actually a double bottom right there. But if you look at the RSI, what did you see with the RSI? RSI moved from low to higher low. You guys see that? Low to higher low. So let's say if you look at a company like Certec, obviously in hindsight, this is something that a lot of people wish they would have participated in. If we go all the way back to when prices bottomed, and I'm not showing this to you in hindsight, this is a trade that I was able to participate in. So what can you see here? You have a clear, low, lower, low, low, higher, low, right? So the application of divergent techniques is just because you see the RSI make a higher low already doesn't mean that you have to enter already. We normally teach that you always want to wait for the first uptick. And normally, the first uptick is always the first entry point for a divergent setup. Now, so this was an entry at 15. Where is Certec now? It's at 1.5 years later, it's at 50 pesos, right? So let's look at why surpass is being participated in now. You see this low? That's a low of 310. You see this low over here? That's another low of 310, which means that you now have a potential bullish divergence setup in place. And you can see that just looking at the RSI, which is showing you a divergent setup. Now, I'm not saying divergent setups are going to work all the time. So typically, out of 10 divergent setups, I'm going to buy maybe around 3 or 4. I might be cutting. So if you look here, you'll see that if you decide to enter on the first uptick, obviously your cut should be below the obvious support, which is the 310 support over here. So what are other divergent setups? So let's look at, let's say, the PCOMP. This is the subprime crisis. And remember, this high over here preceded a 72% drop in prices. And you'll see a bearish divergence in RSI during that time. You see the divergence? So these are already warning signs that you should already be vigilant and be protective of your positions, or at least if you have stops, then you can tighten those stops. So you guys see that? See a high, higher high, higher high, but you see a high, lower high, lower high. You guys see that? So divergent signals you can use in any time frame. Even in 3 minute, 3 nights ago, I used it to enter a short in a US market, I used a 31 hour minute divergence to short at least a position in the US. But if you look here, the important point you want to keep in mind is that if you have signals from higher time frames, let's say a monthly chart versus a daily chart, which takes more importance, the daily or the monthly? The monthly, right? So if I see a signal like this, let's say in the weekly or the monthly, or even if you look at the quarterly, if you look at the quarterly, mas masama pa dito. But if you look at, if you see a signal like this in the monthly, it doesn't mean that you should be racing to your computer and selling all of your positions like a madman. Hindi. It just means that, remember, who is the most important decision in the hierarchy of decision making? It's price, not the indicator, right? The worst thing that you can do, and this used to happen to me a lot, is that I would always make decisions because of fear of divergence. Which means that I would see the divergence already and I would already prematurely act on it without waiting for price confirmation. Which means that if you see a setup like this, you still want to rely on a price trigger or a price signal to trigger selling a position. Whether that's a breakdown of your 32-day moving average, or in this case, if you have a rule to never hold below the 65-day moving average, as what you just learned, you can use that. The final, obviously, is your moving average and your uptrend line. Those are your final points where you don't want to be holding positions past then. Obviously, prior to that, you can simply use your candlestick reversals when you have, let's say, your... in this case, you have, I think, a tweezer top over there with your monthly chart. You have a tweezer top. Once you see the follow-through day, then you can begin selling there. So these are, you always want to be able to use the divergence as a first step and use price as a second step to be able to lead your decision-making. Because if you're making a decision simply based on divergence, and that's happened, that can happen sometimes. Like, for example, DNL, I think 3-4 years ago, I prematurely sold DNL. I was able to buy it at around 5-6 pesos. I sold it at around 9.50 instead of holding it until 20 bucks. Why? Because I saw a divergence. I didn't wait for price for the divergence to manifest itself in price, and I prematurely sold all my positions, right? So you always want to wait for price to confirm that lapse in momentum that is being seen in your RSI. Because if you have a divergence in place, what could simply happen is you could simply have one big buyer buy up the price and push your RSI back to a level where the divergence is no longer present. I think that's the divergence technique. So divergence technique you can use, for me, if I'm participating in downtrending issues, I typically never buy just because it's oversold. I always wait for bullish divergence setups before participating in downtrending issues. But other than that, I'm always going to prefer to participate in uptrending issues.